Please subscribe to my channel and do hit the bell icon. Hello to all dear students. In this video, we'll be discussing about the drug nomenclature. Every drug has three names. These are, first of all, chemical name, secondly, non-proprietary name, also known as generic name, and lastly, proprietary name, also known as trade name or brand name. So first of all, checking out the chemical name. As name only says, the name is depend upon the chemical composition. These are given according to chemical constituent of the drug. So the chemical gives exact chemical composition of the drug, places atoms or molecular structure. But this method of nomenclature is quite cumbersome and not suitable for use in prescribing the drugs. Secondly, checking out the non-proprietary name, also known as the official name. It is assigned by the United States Adopted Name Council, that is USAN Council. It is uniform all over the world. Okay, so this non-proprietary name, it is the name accepted by the competent scientific body and the scientific authority. There are many older drugs that still have more than one non-proprietary name. Like for example, meperidine and pethidine. Both are one and the same and both are the non-proprietary name, or you can say official name. Similarly, you might have heard about lidocaine and lignocaine. Both are one and the same. Next, generic name. Typically derived from the chemical name, usually shorter. See, as such, in normal parlance, the generic name is used in place of non-proprietary name. But as such, this is incorrect because generic should be applied to the chemical or pharmacological group of the compound. However, this misnomer is unlikely to be corrected because of wide usage, including that in the official parlance. Lastly, talking about the proprietary name. It is given by the pharmaceutical manufacturer. Trade name. Name registered by the manufacturer. Trademark symbols will be there. Only be used by the single manufacturer. Same drug may have several trade names depending on the number of manufacturers. The first letter of the name is capitalized. Now we'll have an example of chemical name, non-proprietary name and trade name, or you can say the proprietary name or brand name. Like for example, acetyl salicylic acid. This is the chemical constituent. And we know this chemical constituent in the form of aspirin. Okay. So if you want to take aspirin, so aspirin contains the chemical constituent of acetyl salicylic acid. And if you go to any medical store or any pharmacy, you have to say the trade name like Disprin and Ecosprin. You know, Disprin and Ecosprin, these both contain same salt, that is aspirin, and aspirin contains the chemical constituent, that is acetyl salicylic acid. It is also available under the trade name of Bayer's aspirin in USA. So this is all about the drug nomenclature. I hope you people found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.